Hey everybody, and welcome back to the garden. Today, a buddy of mine, Jay Ivy, called me and said that he thinks he's got army worms in his yard, so we're going to go out there to his house and check it out. But Jay, tell me, how did you notice it and when?
Well, a couple days ago, I started seeing brown spots, and it looked like somebody might have weed-eated in the grass a little bit. And then I started looking, and there was little worms. So this morning, when I come out, I started looking at the grass, and the grass was moving everywhere. And there's not hundreds, and there's not thousands. There's literally millions. This yard will probably be gone in 2 days.
Some of the things you need to know about your army worm when you do notice them in your yard, because here in Georgia, we'll start seeing them around June. But August is when you're really mainly going to notice them, because they've grown to a larger population. But if you want to understand about your army worms, you do need to know a little bit about the biology of them. And what happens is, from more southern areas than here, we'll get flights of them, of the moth, into Georgia. And they are all over the United States. But we'll get the flights in here in Georgia, and they'll start to lay their eggs on the blades of the grass. They'll lay their eggs on your outdoor furniture, any kind of light colored rocks. And within about 2 weeks, the caterpillars hatch out and they start eating on your grass. And that's what you're noticing, Jay.
Yeah, they're eating it.
And usually it is around August when you'll notice them. They attack hay fields and pastures. And so your yield on your hay or your foraging in your pasture is going to be knocked down to just about nothing, because they will eat the blades all the way down to the crown. So there's a few things you can do to take care of that. And today Jay is going to use a Bayer product, and it contains Imidacloprid. That's going to be your active ingredient in it. And he's just going to spray them. And the best time to spray is either early in the day or late in the evening. So Jay got a big old sprayer, and he's going to spray them.
I'm going to spray now, and I'm going to spray again this afternoon.
All right. If you look in this area right here, you can literally see some of the damage that has been done, where the army worm eats the blades down to the crown of the grass. It totally denudes the grass, and it should be okay. It usually takes a couple, 3 weeks for your grass to come back out. But normally it's going to be okay. It doesn't usually kill it all the way. But you can see how it just makes it look ugly. Bare spots.
Now I went and got the stuff. This actually came from Home Depot. They said it was good for army worms. This says it makes 80 gallons. And I got a 35-gallon sprayer right here that does about 6 foot, and I'm gonna coat my yard real good with it right now, and then I'm gonna wait till later this evening and give it another good coat.
Now, a good way to find out if you have the army worms in your pasture or your yard or your hay field, you can actually go out there with a 5 gallon bucket of soapy water, just like dish soap and water. And you pour it on top of the ground starting about June, and what will happen is the worms that are right up under the soil, they will literally come up out of the ground because they don't like the soap. And that way you can tell if you have the worms. You might want to try that in June, and again in July, and again in August before it gets too bad. And if you end up having the worms in your hay field or your pasture, you really want to pay close attention, because it won't take but about a week for them to totally eat the grass all the way down to the crown. And the best way to control them that way is to use a product that is called Lannate, or you can just use Sevin. I would suggest using those two in your pasture or your hay field. If you want to use something in your yard, you can use anything with the active ingredient in it called Imidacloprid or saturate, and that should take care of your problems. One of the things you'll notice on your army worm is they start out to, they're small, but they're going to be really, really green as a younger caterpillar, and as they get older, they do get darker, and their stripes become usually more apparent. and the stripes run from the head all the way to the rear, and they do come from a moth. When the army worm moth does lay her eggs, those egg masses can contain several hundred baby worms in them, and each female can deposit several of these clusters. And the eggs are usually green at first, but they'll change to brown later on. Temperatures do influence the period of time until the eggs will hatch, and when it's a rainier weather, the caterpillars actually enjoy this type of weather. And if you watch how the army worm acts, when they're younger, they tend to congregate in one area, but as they age, they do scatter to look for food. And they feed mostly during the day. When the army worm is full grown, they're about 1 1/3 inches in length. And they can be tan or green or black. And when they are in the larval stage, it takes usually about 12 days before they hatch. And once we get closer to the fall, usually a frost will kill these larvae. But it's best to take care of them in your yard. And you do need to watch for them every year. Your army worms usually love your warm season grasses like Bermuda grass or St. Augustine grass. And others can be attacked. But the cool season grasses that they like is like bluegrass and ryegrass and your fine fescues and your bent grass. Those are your preferred cool season turf grasses. Now, like I said earlier, your army worms will eat the blades of the grass all the way down to the crown. But if you have a newly established lawn or turf or sod, they can actually kill it. But most of the time, if your yard is already established, they're not going to kill it out completely. But it will take a couple, 3 weeks for your yard to bounce back, and you'll start noticing a little bit more green where it's starting to come back. Appreciate you watching today, and I hope you learned a little something about your army worms. And we're going to help Jay keep an eye on this problem, and we'll let you know how it goes. Thanks for watching here back at the garden.